Hey, what's up friends? Welcome back to another awesome video where I will show you some cool tricks to spice up your project. Today, I am going to teach you how to create a gradient or washout effect on any fabric using Photoshop and Cloth3D. Trust me, this is super easy and fun and it will make your design looks amazing. So let's get started. First, we need to open Photoshop and create a new file. I already have this denim texture that I used for a previous project, but you can use any texture you want. Just go online and search for denim texture or whatever fabric you like. Then open the file in Photoshop and add a new layer on top of it. This is where we will add the colors of our gradient effect. Now open your gradient editor and choose the color you want to use. Since we are going for a washout effect, we will definitely need some white in there. But you can also add other colors to make it more interesting. Just make sure that the first and the last color are the same, so that the gradients look smooth and seamless. Otherwise, it might look weird and choppy. But hey, it's your design, so feel free to experiment. Once you have your gradient ready, apply it over the denim texture with the new layer selected. Then change the blend mode of this layer to overlay. This will make the gradient blend with the texture and give it a realistic look. You can see how the texture is still visible underneath the color, right? That's what we want. Now merge both layers together and save the file as a JPG file. And that's it for Photoshop. We are done with the first part of our tutorial. Now we need to open Cloth3D and import our image as a texture. I already have this cool over jacket that I want to apply our gradient effect to. But remember, we are not going to use it as a graphic because that would not look good. If you want to know the difference between texture and graphic in Cloth3D, check out my previous video where I explain everything. So import the image as a texture and apply it to the jacket. You might notice that the effect is not very visible at first. That's because we have some color applied to the fabric already. To fix that, just select the white as a base color of the fabric and voila! You can see how our gradient effect looks awesome on the jacket now. You can adjust the size and positions of the texture as you like and play around with the different settings until you are happy with the result. And that's it for today's Cloth3D tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this video and learned some useful tips and tricks. Now before you go, I want to remind you about our Cloth3D online course that will teach you everything you need to know about this amazing software. Don't miss this opportunity to learn from the best and take your skills to the next level. Just click on the link below and sign up today. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next tutorial. Until then, keep designing and have fun!